The first round of the 2021 NFL Draft is officially in the books, which means we can talk winners and losers. What is going on, y'all? Fox Sports Talk back at it with another video talking, of course, some NFL. I'm here to talk about the 2021 NFL Draft and give my winners and losers to you guys. But before I do, if you're new to the channel, hit the big red subscribe button down below. Make sure you're notified every time I drop a new video by hitting the bell icon. And guys, follow me on all my social media platforms. Links is always down below for that. So let's get into it. All right, so here we go. Winners and losers of the 2021 NFL Draft. Let's start with the winners, all right? Let's start on a positive note here. The biggest winner of the entire draft, I believe, so far. And yes, you might think I'm biased, but I don't think this is a biased pick. I think a lot of you would agree with me. I believe it's the Chicago Bears, all right, with their drafting of Justin Fields, not only because they moved up to get him, but I believe the requisite capital they had to give up to get Justin Fields from the Giants, who obviously traded down with the Bears, I don't think it was a lot. I don't think they gave up their entire future to move up, which is obviously another plus in taking a guy who you think can be the franchise quarterback of the future on a Bears team that starved for one ever since the franchise even began, all right? And this is a kid with superstar potential. And keep in mind here, when I talk about winners and losers, I could say, okay, the Jaguars are a winner for drafting Trevor Lawrence, but they didn't really have to do anything, right? They got the number one pick, and they were going to take Trevor Lawrence. Whoever had the number one pick was going to take Trevor Lawrence. So I can't really say they're a winner in that aspect. The Bears had the number 20th overall pick. They had to maneuver in order to go up and get Justin Fields. They had to see how the draft played out. They had to see, okay, is he going to make it past the top 10? How far can he drop? The Patriots are at 15. We got to jump the Patriots. How far do we have to jump? So you have to calculate all that. That was a shrewd move by Ryan Pace, who I've been very critical of, but he deserves his praise here, and so does head coach Matt Nagy. A home run hit, getting Justin Fields, the second best quarterback potentially in this year's draft class, maybe even the best. Who knows? So love that. Chicago Bears, big winners. New England Patriots, I got to tell you, I'm not the biggest fan of Mac Jones, but the fact that the Patriots did not have to give up any capital to get him, they got him right where they were at, 15, and he fits a clear need. You have Cam Newton. Mac Jones can sit and learn from him. I thought it was a great pick. So I think that the Patriots are winners here because all they did in free agency was address everything but quarterback, and that's what I was angry about. But now you take your guy of the future, and Mac Jones, who, again, doesn't have the highest ceiling, but you put him with Bill Belichick, you put him with that team, the Patriots, and they know how to obviously win. A good defense, a solid skill level players now that you added with Jonnu Smith, Hunter Henry, etc. I think Mac Jones is in position to succeed, so I think the Patriots are winners as well. Another team that I really like what they did, the Chargers. They got Rashawn Slater, who dropped to them. You know, a lot of people thought he could be a potential top 10 pick, and they are really going all in to invest their franchise quarterback in Justin Herbert, and I don't blame them one bit. And speaking of that, I'm not going to say that they're a loser here because they got a fantastic player, but I did not like the Bengals taking Ja'Marr Chase at number 5. I thought they should have taken Penei Sewell, who dropped to the Lions at 7. Folks, Joe Burrow has a big scar in his knee for a reason, okay? He obviously got hurt last year, and every time Bengals fans look at that, I'm sure they get scared. Another receiver, especially one that he played with at LSU, is great, but you want your quarterback upright. I would have taken some protection to protect my franchise quarterback and taken an offensive lineman instead of a receiver, so just want to point that out, but I don't think Ja'Marr Chase is a bad pick. Again, he's going to be a stud as well. So I like what the Chargers did. I like what the Vikings did. All right, at number, I believe, 22, they took Christian Darrisaw, 23, from Virginia Tech. So, look, Rich Spielman, he's a shrewd GM, so I like what they did, get some value there, obviously addressing the offensive line. So I like that. The Ravens, they got Rashad Bateman. They needed a receiver in the first round. They got one, so I think he dropped down. He's a steal at where they got him. Where did they get him at? Number 27. So that was a fantastic move by the Ravens, all right? So I loved that. So again, for me, the winners, the Bears, the Pats, the Chargers, the Ravens, the Vikings. All right, so now let's talk about the losers, all right? Who do I have as the losers in this draft? And I can't start anywhere but the Green Bay Packers. I'm sorry. Like, The Green Bay Packers came into the draft already as losers after the Aaron Rodgers story broke, and I obviously posted my thoughts about that, so if you want to know more, check that video out. But not only do you obviously have Aaron Rodgers, who's pissed off at you and wants out, your franchise quarterback wants out, then you go ahead and you rub him in the nose by taking a cornerback in Eric Stokes with your first-round draft pick. So you had a chance again, after he said he was pissed off and wants out, to get him some help, and you take a cornerback. Now again, hear me out, Packers fans. It is a need. Kevin King isn't very good. Gave up those touchdown passes against the Buccaneers, and cornerback was a position of need. I get that. But listen, nothing else, literally nothing else matters right now besides making Aaron Rodgers happy. Nothing else. So to me, this is the Packers, again, putting themselves in the position which got them in here, which is a pissed off Aaron Rodgers. You never drafted Jordan Love, this would have never happened. And instead, you had a chance to say, okay, Aaron, listen, let's reconcile. We hear you. We're going to give you another receiver. We're going to give you another weapon. Do you feel better? No, we'll take a cornerback. So this you get what you deserve, Green Bay. That's the problem here. Eric Stokes could be a fantastic player, folks, but the problem is, right now, it's all about Aaron Rodgers, and you did not do, I believe, what needed to be done to make Aaron Rodgers happy. So, to me, I think the Green Bay Packers are big losers here. All right, moving on, the Raiders, all right? The Raiders pick, I believe it was at 17. They took Alex Leatherwood from Alabama, the offensive lineman. This was a reach. The Raiders have a draft problem. They do this every year, it seems like. They reach for somebody who they could have had literally a few picks, 10, 15, 20 picks down the line. Like, really, I don't know why they continually reach for guys, but they do. This was another reach. No business going as high as he did. I'm not saying he doesn't address a need. Obviously, they lost Rodney Hudson, or they traded him, but I think it was a reach. I think it was a complete reach. So, Raiders, you're a loser. Giants, look, I'm happy that they traded with my Bears to get Justin Fields, and I think they got a good haul in return. But I think they're a loser because they took another receiver, all right, at the pick that they had it at. At number 20, they took Kadarius Toney. Kadarius Toney could be a good receiver. You didn't need one. You just signed Kenny Galladay. You have Sterling Shepard. You have Evan Ingram, who's a great pass catcher. You need some more help on the defense. You need more help elsewhere. Offensive line, maybe. So I didn't like the pick at all in terms of position. Sorry, I think they're a loser there. All right, and then those are pretty much my main losers here. I do want to go back and talk about one pick that I really did like. And I guess I don't want to say if they're a winner, but I did want to acknowledge it. It's the Steelers taking Najee Harris at number 24. Fantastic, fantastic pick. Look, I know everybody says you don't take running backs that early, folks, but man, talk about a hand-in-glove fit. Talk about literally picture-perfect fit here. Najee Harris going to help out the Steelers. I had that in my mock draft. I'm sure everybody did. I'm not taking that much credit here, but I love the pick. I love the pick. And folks, look, you draft running backs, you run them to the ground, and then you draft another one. Now, look, that's what you do if you're a smart franchise. And the Steelers know they need to take some, you know, load off Big Ben, and Najee Harris can do that. So I loved it. So again, to recap for you guys, winners of the draft: Bears, Patriots, Chargers, Ravens, Vikings. Losers: Broncos, Raiders, Packers, Giants. And that's what I got. So let me know what you guys think. Oh, and one more, actually. One more loser pick. I can't believe I almost forgot this. The Jaguars taking Travis Etienne. I can't even pronounce his last name. The running back from Clemson at number 25. This was a boneheaded draft pick. A boneheaded draft pick, folks. You have James Robinson, who had a phenomenal rookie year. You sign Carlos Hyde in free agency. Get some damn defensive help. Get some offensive linemen. Get some help on areas of need. Why are you drafting a running back? See, this is the perfect example here, right? Running back is a good pick if you need it in the first round, but it's an awful, horrendous, horrible pick if you don't need it. That's why I'm trying to be fair here. I liked what the Steelers did with Najee Harris. I hated what the Jaguars did with Travis Etienne. So that was awful. All right, I'm going to put them as a loser. I can't believe it. I can't put them as a loser because they died. Trevor Lawrence. That's why I didn't put them there, okay? But I hated the pick. Love the Najee Harris pick. Hate the Travis Etienne pick. So there you have it, folks. Let me know what you guys think. Leave me a comment down below if you agree or disagree, as always. Thanks for watching.